Well, hello there, beautiful. How are you feeling today? Welcome to my channel, guys. Welcome back to my channel for all my returning subscribers. How is everybody feeling? Firstly, if you are new here, hello, my name is Asha Christina. Very nice to meet you. Welcome to the A-Team. Hopefully you subscribe. Make sure that those post notifications are turned on so that you are notified every single time that I post. Also, do not forget to follow me on Instagram, which will be right over here. Make sure that you are signed up for my mailing list, the A-List, so that you get exclusive info before it hits this channel, before it hits the public, on what's going on with me. I have a monthly newsletter called the Quality Queen Digest that lets you know everything that's going on with me in general on this channel for the month. And as you guys know, if you don't know, now you know, I have a podcast called Quality Queen Control, and a new episode comes out every single Monday, and that is available on Spotify, Apple, and pretty much all places where podcasts are streaming. All of the information that I said will be listed in my description box below. And lastly, you guys already know the drill here. The Quality Queen comment of the day is, I just wanted to say thank you, Asha. I have been watching your videos for over a year now, and you've changed my life tremendously. You're truly godsend, and I know for a fact God is speaking to me through you. Keep doing what you're doing. This really, really warmed my heart and touched me, because actually when I started writing these video treatments and kind of, you know, started talking about things outside of dating, because hello guys, life exists outside of dating and boys, I really felt led to talk to you guys about yourselves and just really talking about subjects that require you guys to dig deeper and really help you guys figure out your purpose and what you want to do with your life and just talk about things that are more fulfilling. So it's really, really nice and reassuring to know that I'm definitely aligned and on the right path when I see you guys comment things like that. So without further ado, let's get right into this video. 5 ways to improve your self-control. How timely is this right now? Because probably a lot of us are snacking a little bit too much. I mean, I just started dialing it back. Like, can I tell you, like, can I say this thing? I literally just started working out again. I have not worked out in this entire quarantine. I can count on one hand how many times I've actually worked out. Thumbs up this video if you agree. So we're gonna start right off here with tip number one, willpower. So willpower represents strength or a psychological energy that an individual uses to resist temptation in order to work hard towards their intended goal. Now, because self-control depends on your strength, your energy, willingness to do something, people usually resort to willpower, your willingness to do something when you exert that self-control. I know that sounds a little bit confusing, but actually think about it. So when you no longer feel like you have the self-control to do something, what is your willingness, your willpower to be able to push through how you feel and get it done regardless? Because at the end of the day, self-control is essentially delaying self-gratification in service of a long-term goal. Number two, resist temptation. I know this is way easier said than done, guys. Trust and believe me, we all have our different areas and where we struggle. This is definitely something that is multifaceted because it requires various components. For instance, you definitely need to control your environment. If, let's say, resorting to talking about exercising, health, nutrition, weight, for the vast majority, you want to make sure that you're not bringing in those junk foods into your home because you're more likely going to eat them if they're in your home. You have to change your environment. If you completely remove that, you will be able to resist it because it's not there. Life is hard enough. We have to resist a lot of things. We already have to resist texting our exes, and God, don't make this harder for yourself. The least you could do is not buy those bag of Deep Valley chips in sweet onion flavor. This is getting personal. I'm triggered. I think I'm talking about myself. But nonetheless, I digress. I just wanna add though that those chips are really good. I think it's called Deep Valley. It could be called Deep River. They're really good, guys. And I'm not encouraging you to go buy them, but okay, maybe you should try them, but don't buy the big bag. Definitely 8 an entire bag in 2 days. Let's get back on track here. Don't buy them so that you can resist the temptation. For instance, I knew for me, I went through an entire loaf of bread one time because I bought my favorite cream cheese, Miyoko's vegan cream cheese, and it was in lox flavored, and I never had lox before because I've been vegan for so long, I didn't even know what lox was until now. And I tasted that and I was mind blown. I was like, wow, a whole new world. So I ate an entire loaf of bread. Regrets. I regretted it. It never happened again. I make sure that I intentionally do not buy that flavor because I do not want that in my house because I will ransack through that. So booms, straight like that. We already have to muster up the willpower to exercise and burn off, you know, the calories and things like that that we already consume. So you don't want to make this harder for yourself by actively engaging in self-sabotage when you have a goal. Number three, shift your perspective. So the more taxing that we perceive something to be, the more we view self-control as something that degrades over time. So it's as simple as this. If you make it an extremely daunting task, you're more likely to give in to temptation. This is why I always stress, in general, do not try to cultivate healthy habits out of negative thoughts or a negative mindset, because then it's going to come from a place of reprimandation or punishment, and you're not going to do what's good for you in service of the long-term goal. So if you perceive something to be so daunting, even though sometimes it is, the bigger it's going to be, you're not going to want to do it, and you're more tempted because what happens? Whatever you chase runs, right? Whatever you say no to, you want to just make it a yes. If someone says no to you, you know, it makes you want to do it more. So what can help with this is think about your why to encourage your desire to pursue action. In life right now, I feel like it is about delaying gratification in service of something else, especially millennials. Okay, this chick right here. We have to learn how to be comfortable with delaying gratification in service of a long-term goal. Not everything is going to be 1, 2, 3. Because why? Every single decision that you've made up until now led you right to this moment right here. Number four, confidence. Yes, you can. And you will. If you are doing something and you genuinely do not believe that you can achieve it, then you won't have any motivation. If you already have the defeated mindset of this isn't going to work, I don't want to do this, well then it's not going to work and you won't really want to do it, or you simply won't do it at all. However, if you do believe that you can achieve something, you're more likely to continue your efforts and master that task no matter what difficulties may arise. Are you up for the challenge? And yes, sometimes we have to, you know, fake it a little bit till we make it. There's going to come a time where that happens. You're not always going to believe in every single thing that you do. That's a very normal thing, guys. Again, healing isn't linear. Growth isn't linear. It's painful. It requires so many different things. Awareness, vulnerability, all of these components on your journey. And it's a lot of emotion to, you know, muster through and wrestle with. But you can do it. And people that truly want to get to know themselves, that take the time out to go through these steps in life, it's just the road less traveled. So what team do you want to be on? The A team or where the basic betties are? And lastly, number five, commit. Listen, Angel, your freedom is found in your commitment to all that you do, to anything that you do. That's where your freedom is going to come from. Think about the things that you value and things that you want to invest your time in. I think that the reason why especially I wanted to start even talking about these topics is because it's so easy to get so lost in, is this relationship working and what does this guy want? We are so focused on building and cultivating those external relationships when they come secondary to ourselves, really. And it's so easy to utilize these things as a distraction instead of really just working on ourselves, because it's fun and it feeds your ego. I mean, who doesn't want to be in love? Who doesn't want to be in a relationship? And if you're not in a loving relationship or a healthy dynamic, half the time we're complaining over how we got played or you know, what this guy did that made us upset, all of these different things. But what about you? The men will always be there. I promise you, they're not going anywhere. So you need to focus on you, babe. It's go time, baby. It is your time. Commit to you. And it's important to master this, because once you do, it will get easier and easier. You will fall, but you will get back up, bounce back faster. Sometimes I feel like people think that because they get over a certain thing that there won't be tests to make sure that they're really over it. No, life is always going to continue to test you, and it's your job to just pass those tests. Commit to yourself before you decide to commit to another individual, before you exhaust all your energy in wondering why another individual isn't committing to you. You commit to you. Think about that. If I wouldn't even commit to myself, why would I expect somebody to commit to me? Consider how hard it is to change yourself when you're thinking of changing another person. Think about that. Powerful. So angels, I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Please let me know if you guys actually like this new format of me listing all these tips on the side. I figured it would be easy for you guys to take notes. It's also a nice visual to just have all of the tips on the side as well. So with that being said, angels, do not forget that I love you and God loves you, and I will see you guys in my next video. Mwah.